The world has got the shock in the second half of the year, as you all know. Turkey is bouncing back much quicker than the rest of the world. And if I see the consumer sentiment will sustain probably in the first quarter of the year. But because of the high inflation rates, we expect some cool down of the economy. Coming back to European markets, although the growth rates are not public in all countries, we see some also rebounding in the European countries. Coming back to COVID cases, we at Sabancı Holding is closely managing it since last February. We had two major concerns, one, health of our employees, and then the sustainability of the jobs. We have started the crisis with the motto of we will not leave anyone behind. And today we have started the pandemic with 60,000 employees, and hopefully we will be coming out of the pandemic like that. That delivers very strong results for Sabancı Holding.
The lira obviously based back in November of last year, but as we've come into this year, there seems to have been a brightening in terms of the view of how the Turkish economy is going to fare. I think some changes in the team around the central bank and the government, and also the prospects of some progress on the reopening of the economy, as you've mentioned there. But what difference will that strengthening of the lira make to your exporting operations?
Two things. We agree with you that the new central bank governor and the new economy ministers are in close contact with the economic partners, and they are taking the right measures to strengthen Turkish economy. Since the beginning of the pandemic, actually, in Turkey, the manufacturing industry has not stopped, and we continued in operation in Turkey, also at Sabancı Holding, especially in manufacturing. And our exports to main markets, especially to Europe, has increased during this time. And we expect that because of this supply chain continuity, supply chain security, this will stick to Turkey.
Good morning to you, sir. Should I worry about the debt levels that Turkey has taken on board during this crisis? I've been looking across the board from households to corporates to government as well, and there are big increases across the board. If we do see tighter financing going forward, could this be one of the old problems for emerging markets returning, sir?
I think that can be a overall problem for all the emerging markets, but if you look since the beginning of the crisis, all Turkish enterprises are trying to correct their balance sheets. And once we come to Sabancı Holding, we had a debt improvement program since last 5 years, and we ended up with a record high performance over there. At Sabancı Holding, our debt to EBITDA ratios are below 2%, very healthy level, and most of the Turkish conglomerates are having similar structures.